Hello everyone, welcome to another video of BioCram. In this video, I am going to talk about gene therapy, which is one of the important subtopics of application of biotechnology. All the subtopics of this chapter are very important, and many times different types of questions based on all these subtopics are being asked in medical entrance tests. So keeping importance of all these subtopics in our mind, let's start with the new subtopic, and that is gene therapy. What is gene therapy? It is a kind of therapy which has been given for the treatment of inherited diseases or genetic disorders. In formal language, we can define gene therapy as it is the technique of genetic engineering to replace a faulty gene by a normal healthy functional gene. Let's understand this definition. Where genes are located? Genes are located in the chromosomes. And genes, they encode certain types of enzymes, and these enzymes are responsible for the synthesis of certain types of proteins, and these proteins are essential for biophysiological function of the body. Suppose there is a gene which is located in the chromosome, and this gene is a faulty gene, and this encodes an enzyme. Since this is a faulty gene, so it will encode a faulty enzyme, or it will not synthesize any kind of enzyme. As a result of this, what will happen? Due to the absence or the faulty enzyme, that particular protein will be not synthesized. So that will lead to a genetic disorder. Here I will take one example, that is muscular dystrophy. Muscular dystrophy is a genetic disorder, and it occurs due to deficiency of a protein, and that is dystrophin. And dystrophin is very important for the contraction of the muscle. So under gene therapy, that this faulty gene is replaced by normal, healthy, and the functional gene. So this is the basic idea behind gene therapy. Now we will see few examples of genetic disorders. Here I have listed few genetic disorders like muscular dystrophy, cystic fibrosis, SCID, which stands for severe combined immune deficiency disorder, and these disorders are caused by single gene defects. Whereas sickle cell anemia, cardiovascular diseases, and diabetes, they are complex genetic disorders. Here we will study in detail about SCID. So let's start. First time, gene therapy was given to 4 years old girl in 1994. ADA deficiency. ADA is an enzyme which is adenosine deaminase, and this enzyme's deficiency leads to a disorder that is SCID, that is severe combined immune deficiency disorder. And this ADA deficiency, it occurs due to deletion of the gene which encodes ADA. So due to deletion of the gene, that ADA deficiency occurs, and ADA is very important for the proliferation of T lymphocyte. T lymphocyte is very important for the immune system to function, and due to improper function of the immune system, children are open to bacterial and the viral infection. Now we will see the methods of treatment for this disorder. These are the few methods of treatment for this kid. The first one is bone marrow transplantation, and the second one is enzyme replacement therapy, in which ADA injections have been given to the patients. These last two methods, they are a kind of gene therapy. The first one here, that is infusion of genetically modified lymphocyte and the replacement of faulty gene, which we'll see in detail here. This slide explains how genetically modified lymphocytes, they are used for the treatment of SCID. In this type of therapy, the lymphocytes, they are extracted from the blood of the patient. Here, from the patient, the lymphocytes are extracted from the blood, and these lymphocytes, they are grown in culture. And with the help of retroviral vector, lymphocytes are introduced with DNA, that is ADA, complementary DNA. By the introduction of this DNA by retrovirus, that this lymphocyte, it becomes genetically modified lymphocytes. And these genetically modified lymphocytes, they are infused into the patient, and this is how SCID is treated by this method. But this method is still, it is not the permanent cure for the SCID, because the lymphocytes, these genetically modified lymphocytes, they are not immortal. So time to time there is requirement of infusion of genetically modified lymphocytes. But still permanent cure is there, and that is by the replacement of faulty gene. So we'll see in the next slide. For the permanent cure, genes which encodes ADA is isolated from the bone marrow, and then it is introduced into the cells in the embryonic stage. And this will be a permanent cure for the SCID. So this was all about the gene therapy. Here I would like to emphasize on one point, that the correct and the early diagnosis is very important for the treatment of any kind of disease. My next topic is related to this, and that is molecular diagnosis.